So we welcome you all as we begin our Mass for the Vigil of Pentecost. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your
brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, preparing ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heaven and King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who of the past of mystery to accomplish us a sign in 50 days, grant that from the scattered nations the confusion of many tongues may be gathered by heavenly grace into one confession of your name, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Thus says the Lord, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions, even upon the servants and the handmaids. In those days, I will pour out my spirit, and I will work wonders in the heavens and on earth, fire, blood, and columns of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood. At the coming of the day of the Lord, the great and terrible day, then everyone shall be rescued who calls on the name of the Lord. For on Mount Zion there shall be a remnant, as the Lord has said, and in Jerusalem survivors whom the Lord shall call. The word of the Lord.
Lord, send out your spirit.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all creation is groaning in labor pains, even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that sees is not hope. For who hopes for what one sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait with endurance. In the same way, the Spirit who comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings, and the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will, the word of the Lord.
According to John. On the last and greatest day of the feast, Jesus stood up and exclaimed, "Let anyone who thirsts come to me and drink. As Scripture says, rivers of living water will flow from within him who believes in me." He said this in reference to the Spirit, that those who came to believe in him were to receive. There was, of course, no Spirit yet, because Jesus had not yet been glorified. The Gospel of the Lord. Part of this new reality is we're sort of doing Mass for us and for those who are not here. So thank you for being patient with our cameras. Okay, so we've been celebrating Pentecost this week. We had Pentecost Sunday on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So this is the fourth Pentecost Sunday and the second one here at St. Mary's. And so I think it's been a kind of a cool chance to reflect on the Holy Spirit. And I hope you've had a chance also on our YouTube channel for St. Mary's. There has been a novena to the Holy Spirit, which is done by some of the parents and teachers for CCD over in Pierce. And so they were good enough to take time the night before and record with their family the prayer for the gifts of the Spirit. And so I think that's been kind of a neat opportunity to pray for the coming of the Spirit. But I think it's kind of crucial that we know what it is that we're praying for. I'm just going to take this. It's a little hard to speak. Okay, so what are we praying for? The coming of the Holy Spirit. And as I said at the Masses this week, one of the things that I notice is many images of the Spirit there are. So there's an image of the Holy Spirit there, the Annunciation, an image of the Holy Spirit here with the Holy Family. And those are just two of the images here at St. Mary's Church. And so the Holy Spirit is a huge part of the coming of faith into the world. And I was listening to this every Saturday morning, where Bishop Lucas gives about a 30-minute podcast, sort of a Zoom thing, I guess, for the priests of the Archdiocese of Omaha and Lincoln. He's, as you know, the administrator of the Archdiocese of Lincoln also. So, and he was talking about the Spirit as a personal renewal. And so, you know, hopefully you've been asking, Holy Spirit, please come into my life. And then the Holy Spirit as one who sends. So, and we'll talk about that a little bit. It's right in our reading.
So first, a personal encounter. It's sort of something that we're all given. I had a baptism about an hour and a half ago in Randolph, and at that moment, this little Nordhuis child was given the Holy Spirit. So that gift is given at baptism and confirmation, and it's the fullness. It's not like, well, here's a sip of the Holy Spirit. That child is filled with the Spirit. That's filled with the gifts of the Spirit. If you've ever been to a confirmation where a bishop is present, you feel tangibly, at least I know I do, and oftentimes the kids do, they feel tangibly the presence of God, the presence of the Holy Spirit. And so, again, those gifts are given. But, as often happens with spiritual gifts, I think, it's sort of like I gave you, let's say I wrapped up a golden ring, a 14 karat gold, beautiful ring, and maybe it's even got diamonds on it, I don't know. Very valuable thing. And because it's so valuable, you know, I was at the jeweler, and I said, please put it in a beautiful box, and then put beautiful paper and ribbon. And then I took this gift and I handed it to you on some special day. Have you received a beautiful gift that's precious? Everybody? Yes, you got it. So I handed it to you, it's yours. Now, you have a gift. It's in a box. You can take that gift, you can put it down, maybe on a shelf, and say, that is so, I've never seen such beautiful wrapping. That is gorgeous. I'm just going to let it sit there for a while. I didn't even want to know what's in there. It's got to be something amazing. Or we could even say, I got a ring open, I got to see what's in there, and then it's so beautiful. I'm like, I can't wear that ring. I mean, I'm just going to take that beautiful ring off and put it somewhere safe. Did I get a gift? Is it precious? Both of those, yes. Is it sitting on a shelf? Yes. Was it made to be worn? Yeah. This isn't, by the way, this is just a rosary ring. But anyway, so that's kind of with the Holy Spirit. We've been given these gifts, wisdom, understanding, knowledge, counsel, piety, fear of the Lord. But are they active? Are they active? So I was listening to, I think it was Fulton Sheen. He was talking about, it was Father Mike Scanlon, the former president of Steubenville University. You know these Steubenville conferences the kids go to? They were started by Father Mike. Man, just on fire with the Spirit. And anyway, he was talking about do not be afraid, which of course is what Jesus says constantly after the resurrection. Don't be afraid. Do not be afraid. But these grown men, they are afraid. And so what Father Scanlon is saying is, if you're going to be afraid of the right thing. Right? To fear offending God. Because that should be really the only fear, apart from, you know, I'm crossing a busy street and I have normal, natural fear. But we shouldn't be controlled by other fears, especially if we have no fear of God. That's dangerous. You know, if I have no sense of I can offend God, but maybe I'm afraid of, you know, whatever, other things in my life, financial things. Okay, well, I understand that. Are you afraid of fearing offending the Lord? Do you even know what that is? I think this is the biggest challenge I find as a priest. People have no idea, no sense at all, no sense of sin. No sense. I mean, again, St. John Paul II, walking, living, breathing saint, every week, going to receive the sacrament of forgiveness. Because he's so aware of the sin in his life, and he's a saint. And yet, you know, we can be walking around, I don't know, it's been like three, four, six, 8 years, months, whatever. You know, bless me, Father, for I have sinned. I don't know. Like maybe one or two things that are really heavy, and that's it. Like, I have no idea that every single day I offend someone, every single day I judge, I gossip. Every single day. And then we wonder, where's the Holy Spirit? Why is my spiritual life so dead? The Spirit cannot come where sin has taken hold. So I think, again, it's not just that there's sin there, but we don't even know it's sin. We have invested nothing in understanding the block to the Holy Spirit. We just want, it's like we just want ice cream sundae. We don't want the whipped cream on top. I'll take the, oh, Holy Spirit, gifts? Like Christmas? I'll take some gifts. But, you know, I don't want to pay for the banana split. I don't want to, you know, I don't want to work to scoop the ice cream. Or make, you know, I just want the good stuff. Because without the Spirit, the church cannot fulfill its mission. The sending was not just for the 12. And they had plenty of reason to object. Jesus, you know, boo, 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 boo. The biggest one being, we're going to die. We're going to be rejected. We're going to be brought before people and persecuted. We're going to be scourged. We're going to be talked about, kicked out of towns. Right? People are going to try to poison us. I mean, they got some real reasons to resist. To resist. And what does Jesus say? Oh, I'm sending you. Go. Go. And again, that go is not for a select few people. Do I feel called to be sent? Do I know there's a call upon my life because of baptism and confirmation? If somebody were to follow me around, would they have any sense that I feel that way? That I know that to be true? So again, the Spirit's coming is a real thing, but again, I don't know what else to do. Like, let's have a novena, and I look at the views, and it's like 40 views, you know, and I'm like, you know, we have roughly, what, you know, 1,000 to 1,500 people in our three parishes. 40 views? And then, that's the problem, right? Where's the preparation? The gifts. And the gifts of the Spirit. And that's why, again, the church needs those gifts to come alive, for parishes to come alive, for people to be activated. Activated to do what? Really to save other people. Right, the Spirit was primarily interested, I'm going to form you guys, I'm going to send you to people who have no idea who Christ is. That's the mission of the church. And I think one of the good things that's come out of this is it's got us out of our routine. Routine is good to a certain extent, right? But it can also be where we get stuck. And if we look at the lives of the 12, they are anything but stuck. You know, they're sent. St. James dies in Spain. St. Thomas dies in India. These guys are sent, and that sending starts today at Pentecost. Are we even feeling sent? I'm sent to bring the Spirit to work. We're not even going to send you to India. You don't have to go to China, right, or to the ends of the earth. Are you willing to go to the grocery store and bring the Holy Spirit? Or your family gathering? Is that part of your reality? And if it's not, then again, you've got to look. For me, where's that blockage? Maybe I don't even know what it means to live like. I mean, there's a scripture we had this week. Paul comes upon a group of people, and he says, have you received the Holy Spirit? And they say, great line, we haven't even so much as heard that there is a Holy Spirit. We received the baptism of Jesus. Oh, Paul says, okay. Well, then I'm going to pray for you people are at, I've never even heard that there's so much, that there is a spirit, or what it's supposed to do, or how do I prepare for it, or it's active in my life. So that's what today's about, and I thought it was beautiful that Archbishop Lucas really kind of, again, encouraged us to remember to remind people, the people, that they're sent by the Spirit.
For all who have been signed and sealed with the Holy Spirit, that His church may be united as one body made of many parts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the outpouring of the Spirit of peace, that men and women may forgive one another and live in the light of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, we pray especially for those in our parish that are sick and in need of our prayers. May the healing spirit of the risen Christ bring light and wholeness to them. We pray to the Lord. For whom? For the parish families of St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jane Francis, for whom this Mass is offered, and for all who have died, that God will open wide the door for them and welcome them to the eternal banquet of heaven. We pray to the Lord. For those who have no one to pray for them, and for all the personal intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we thank you for hearing these prayers and the needs in our hearts. We make you faith through Christ's power.
Thank you.
The mystery of faith. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
brimstone sermon, you know, it's 20 minutes, half an hour. So at the end of Mass, he says to this farmer, "What'd you think?" He says, "Well, I'll tell you what, when that one cow shows up, it won't dump the whole barn on him." So anyway, let us pray. May these gifts we consume benefit us, O Lord. May we always be aflame with the same Spirit who we wondrously poured out upon the apostles through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And
may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. We love to serve the Lord.
Thanks, everybody.